as we think about Brown, the issue of what race means is very much on the table. The Census Bureau struggles with this, how to measure race and those boundaries. But this was very consequential even prior to the Brown decision. And I think it's important that our understanding of Brown record the fact that there were several antecedent decisions that led to the Brown decision. The efforts in Texas and California in particular that were highly consequential for bringing to the fore the ambiguities of race that are playing out today. We've come full circle. 10 years ago, there was a celebration at the Princeton campus about the 50th anniversary, half a century. What have we accomplished, what we haven't? And there was a predominant focus on the black-white gap, the racial gap, and how it manifests itself. But it was really striking to a demographer who has traced the changes in the U.S. population to say, why are we not thinking about the future and what has happened in the U.S. population over this period? And in particular, since 2000, the Hispanic population has superseded the African-American population in size. At the same time, in the same court that after Brown was argued, Hernandez was argued. And so these two decisions together need to be raised and put in parallel for understanding what this implies going forward. Because today, with the changing demography of the population and rising inequality across schools, we have several challenges. We have a resegregation of schools. We have rising income inequality. We have several problems of language that are still not quite dealt with. And these blurry boundaries are continuing to evolve as a nation. We come to terms with what difference means and diversity and how to actually build the new unum out of this pluribus that we are refashioning. We don't, as a nation, have the commitment toward the future the way we did during the post-war period when we democratized education. I think it's time to go back to revisit our values and to think about these two decisions, the Hernandez and the Brown decision, in tandem, and think about them in the context of what we're trying to achieve about equal opportunity, meaning not only racial, ethnic, national origin diversity and the others, but also the groundswell of inequality that has been pulling us apart as a nation, and it is tending by default to reify the meaning and group opportunities, because the poorest kids in the most segregated school tend today to be Latinos and African Americans. Sometimes researchers pick one group to study. So the sociology of me or the education of me. And I think it would be good if more researchers use a comparative frame of reference to understand what the differences are. They'll find that there's a great deal more similarity. It's only by comparison and contrast that we understand what meaning is. And focusing, to the extent that we can focus on some of the processes that are similar across groups and bring that into sharp relief in our policies, we'll be better served.